Apple cider vinegar has long been used in traditional medicines to preserve food and to boost immunity against coughs and colds. In fact, traces have been found in Egyptian urns dating back to 3000 BC. And today, it's making a resurgence as a popular dietary addition, claiming many health benefits. Now, with diabetes, we know the basics are to eat whole foods, reduce refined carbohydrates, and exercise. However, as we've discussed on this channel, there are certain foods like lemon, garlic, and berries that are superfoods when it comes to preventing and managing diabetes. But where does apple cider vinegar fit in? Is it really as good as all the hype suggests? And what about side effects and tooth enamel? Well, today we'll look at the scientific evidence of apple cider vinegar to control diabetes, as well as important things you need to know if you're going to start consuming it, including simple but important rules to follow. But before we dive in, can you do us a favor and like this video? Ring the bell for future notifications and make sure you subscribe to Diabetics Talk for more practical diabetes information. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get 3 free gifts. Also, don't forget to check out exclusive Diabetics Talk merchandise from our store and sign up as a member to get full access to the Food, Health, and You Complete Implementation System documentary and more. Now, what's so special about ACV? The main active compound in apple cider vinegar is called acetic acid. It's what gives vinegar that sour taste and strong odor. But acetic acid is more than just a flavoring agent. It has some serious effects on various bodily processes. One of the key things is how acetic acid impacts blood sugar levels after eating. When you eat food, blood sugar levels naturally rise as your body digests and absorbs the carbohydrates in your meal. For most people, their body is able to regulate these blood sugar levels on its own, but for people with diabetes, this process doesn't work properly. That's where acetic acid comes in. Studies show that acetic acid can lower blood sugar levels after a meal, even in people with type 2 diabetes. This is because acetic acid slows down the digestion of carbohydrates, which in turn slows down the release of glucose into the bloodstream. And if you're a bread lover, we have good news. Bread is generally off limits for diabetics, but in a 2004 study published in the Diabetes Journal, participants were randomly assigned to consume either vinegar or a placebo before eating white bagels. Blood samples were collected fasting and 30 and 60 minutes post-meal for glucose and insulin analysis. When compared to the placebo, vinegar ingestion improved whole body insulin sensitivity during the 60-minute post-meal interval by between 19 and 34%. Now, we're not saying you should go out and eat bagels. In fact, we highly recommend switching to our diabetic-friendly alternatives. But these studies show an exciting benefit of acetic acid for preventing blood sugar spikes associated with eating carbohydrates. Next, many diabetics are concerned about high fasting glucose levels when they wake up in the morning. Well, a 2007 study found that giving diabetic participants 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar before bedtime led to a 4% reduction in fasting blood sugar the next morning. Now, we don't recommend taking it straight. There are a few important steps to follow, and we'll get to that shortly. But the next point we want to quickly cover is fat. While weight loss isn't an issue for all type 2 diabetics, it is extremely important for many. Most importantly, visceral fat. Visceral fat accumulates around organs in the abdominal cavity. This fat is metabolically active and can produce hormones and other substances that can contribute to inflammation and insulin resistance. Excess visceral fat is associated with an increased risk of several health problems, including type 2 diabetes, heart disease, and certain types of cancer. Animal studies discovered that the acetic acid in apple cider vinegar suppressed fat accumulation in animals. Following this, researchers in Japan conducted a study on humans to see if the results could be replicated. In this 12-week double-blind trial, participants drank 500 milliliters of water containing 30 milliliters of vinegar, while a control group drank plain water. At the end of the trial, those who drank the vinegar each day had significantly lower fat than the control group, as well as lower overall body weight, BMI, waist circumference, and serum triglyceride levels. Researchers stated that this reduction in visceral belly fat alone showed a positive improvement for metabolic risk factors such as hypertension, dyslipidemia, and dysglycemia, and may be associated with a 10% reduction in coronary heart disease risk, a common progression from type 2 diabetes. Other studies have shown benefits for cholesterol and blood pressure, both of which are vital for a healthy heart. And there are other upstream benefits of apple cider vinegar too, including your immunity. ACV is packed with vitamins and antioxidants that strengthen the immune system and ward off infections. B vitamins, for example, assist numerous processes in the body, such as delivering oxygen and generating usable energy. Vitamin E helps to protect cells from damage caused by free radicals, preventing infection and reducing inflammation. And what about beta carotene? That's right, the super pigment found in carrots. This antioxidant is converted into vitamin A in the body and is essential for healthy skin, mucous membranes, eye health, and immune function. So not only is apple cider vinegar a potent anti-diabetic food, it's a great food for keeping the whole body going strong. Next, we'll discuss potential side effects and important tips to prevent problems that can occur when it's consumed incorrectly. But first, how about those free gifts? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free Diabetes Fighting documentary. Plus, get a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 delicious and easy to prepare recipes that the whole family will love. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. Now back to the video. Okay, so we've covered how powerful ACV is for combating diabetes and general health. Now, how do you consume apple cider vinegar? Remember we discussed the study that gave participants 2 tablespoons per day? We don't want to start there. One of the primary concerns with apple cider vinegar is the risk of burning the esophagus and causing stomach problems. This is because apple cider vinegar is highly acidic and can damage delicate tissues under certain conditions. To avoid this, it's important to dilute apple cider vinegar with water. It is also important to start with a very small amount of apple cider vinegar and gradually increase the dosage over time, giving your body time to get used to the acidity. Start with 1/2 teaspoon or less mixed into a glass of water and slowly build up over a matter of weeks or months. This minimizes the risk of discomfort or side effects and allows your body to adjust. If you have any discomfort, reduce the dosage or stop consuming it altogether. Some people may be more sensitive than others, and it's important to listen to your body and adjust accordingly. Now, when to take apple cider vinegar? Some experts recommend first thing in the morning, after brushing your teeth, and at least 20 minutes before eating. Allowing a little time before eating will allow it to cleanse the digestive system and prevent bloating. Other people like to have it before lunch or dinner, especially if that's a heavier carbohydrate meal, to get those full glucose regulating benefits. And for others who are trying to address high fasting glucose in the morning, choose to take it at night before going to bed. However, if you choose to do it, start small and listen to your body. If it bothers your stomach, then reduce your dosage. Finally, there are a few precautions to consider. Talk with your doctor first before you're taking medication. Some medications, such as those to lower blood sugar, may have interactions with ACV. If you have gastroparesis, this may be problematic, so talk to your doctor. The next point is tooth enamel. As an acidic drink, too much exposure can erode the protective layer of enamel on your teeth, just like soda or lemon can. To minimize the risk of enamel erosion, drink it through a straw. Using a straw helps to bypass your teeth and minimize the contact between the acidic vinegar and tooth enamel. You may also like to rinse your mouth with water after drinking apple cider vinegar, and avoid brushing your teeth immediately afterward, as the acid can temporarily soften tooth enamel. Now, all that may sound like a lot, but it's worth the effort when you consider the health benefits. Just remember the 3 Ds for diabetes: dilute, drink through a straw, and don't brush your teeth straight after. And if you prefer not to drink it, try using it in a salad dressing. Simply mix apple cider vinegar with your choice of lemon juice, olive oil, mustard, and black pepper, and presto, you've got a zesty dressing that's good for your health. Finally, it's important to choose raw and organic apple cider vinegar that still contains the mother. The mother refers to a colony of beneficial bacteria and enzymes that are present in raw, unfiltered apple cider vinegar. The mother appears as a cloudy substance in the vinegar and is a sign of high-quality, unprocessed vinegar. The beneficial bacteria in the mother support a healthy gut microbiome, and the enzymes are key to breaking down food and improving nutrient absorption. Choosing organic is important to avoid harmful chemicals. Organic apple cider vinegar is made from organically grown apples, which are free from pesticides, herbicides, and fertilizers. By choosing raw and organic with the mother, you can be sure that you're getting the benefits we discussed. And there you have it. Apple cider vinegar is an excellent addition for diabetics or anyone looking to improve their health. It helps to normalize blood sugar and insulin function, has various benefits for the heart, boosts immunity, accelerates visceral fat loss, and promotes vibrant skin. Remember to dilute, drink with a straw, and don't brush your teeth afterward. Start with half a teaspoon and slowly increase up to 2 tablespoons if you feel comfortable. And always go for raw and organic apple cider vinegar with the mother. Now it's your turn. Have you tried apple cider vinegar? Did you have success with it? We'd love to hear your experiences, as well as any tips you have to share with the community. Leave a comment below this video and share with the group. If you're still watching, that probably means you enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to click like, subscribe to our channel, and hit that bell button. And don't forget, you can claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. We want to keep making informative, research-based videos for you. So if you gained value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. We're Diabetics Talk, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you prevent and fight diabetes. Thanks for watching, and we hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.